Some people say we're all connected. All part of some bigger picture. Some harmonious flow, endless and meaningful. Maybe that's how it looks from a distance. But up close, with eyes open, I see no evidence of any spiritual choreographer at work. No, I see nothing but the random fractals of a selfish, queenless hive. Never looking, never stopping, never meeting. Don't get me wrong, yeah? I'm not judging anyone. I mean, I want to get home as fast as the next person. But is it my unwavering selflessness that allows others to go before me? Or the selfish knowledge that the last one will be the first off? Who would fool themselves to believe anything but the latter? Idle minds, too lazy to think beyond the following of that earth. Like it or not, life's a sinister competition, an endless series of choices, large or small, each with its own set of probabilities. All wind. Now that is an 80% chance. This is my train. It's worth a dash.
Excuse me,
random variables. Never underestimate the human factor.
Bond Street.
Bond Street. It's on the other platform.
Thank you. Two cars out, the rest are logged. Should be a nice, quiet night. See you tomorrow.
Yeah, we'll do.
And here they are. The most meaningful relationship I've ever had in my life, with a bunch of metal bimbos. Look at you, my beauty. You could keep me in college for over a decade.
Careful the way he saturates it with his ego. Ah, here he is. Did you put all wrongdoers to flight?
You can leave the keys to me, sir. I'll park the car for you.
I'm not the driver, son.
I do beg your pardon, madam.
No problem.
No tip.
Him or her? Fuck.
Thank you.
You know, sometimes choices are so small you don't even see them. You are your decisions, that's what shapes you. And that last one shaped me into a little bit of a chauvinist, just like that pig in a suit.
Get something?
Not exactly.
I'm sorry about before, you know, just assuming like that.
Oh, ignore him. He was being an arsehole.
I think your boyfriend's an arsehole.
Don't you? But he does have a nice car. What are you reading?
Just a little bit of light study.
Looks pretty heavy to me.
Can I help you with something?
need a favor. I need the keys to the Maserati.
Does Dr. Brent know?
Of course he does.
Okay. Okay, then you won't mind signing for it then.
Okay, he doesn't know. It's a secret, but I really need those keys. It's just for tonight. I'll be back before 2. Before 1?
Okay.
Good boy.
What's in it for me?
I'll owe you one.
One what?
One favor.
How do I know you're good for your favors?
You can bank my favors.
I want to know why you need the car.
We don't need to worry about that.
Fine.
I won't.
Okay. I made a bet. A stupid bet that I could turn up at this party in a Maserati.
That was rash. How much is the bet for?
£1,000.
£1,000?
100 of it is yours, if you let me have those keys.
Forget it. There is no way I'm letting you drive a £200,000 car out of here tonight, all right?
What?
Look, no more fast cars tonight, all right?
Turn around. Slowly. Now get over here. Drop it. The security guard pay you enough to be a hero. Smart. Now get in the car. Oi, dickhead. Does it look like I can drive? You get behind the wheel.
You want me to drive you out of here?
That's exactly what you're gonna do.
Student. Okay, I've got no money. My family's got no money. I'm worth nothing to you.
You're done now. Get in the house.
Gates, no option. Wall, 90% chance I'll get shot, but he's injured. Make it 70. Chance he shoots in this neighborhood, though, 30% max. So the chance of taking a bullet is less than 21. Is it worth a try? No way. Might as well play Russian roulette.
Change your gear.
Just want to make sure I look the part.
And I want to make sure we're up on checking gears. Who the fuck is that?
is the night guard.
What happened to your arm?
He fell 15 feet onto a concrete floor.
This is your idea of a slick operation. Dripping DNA all over the place, kidnapping the first innocent bystander.
I got the card, didn't I? It's outside.
Jesus Christ! And who the hell's gonna drive? Because you're clearly not.
I'll be all right.
Fucking idiot. It has to be four people. There is no way you can manage the auction assistant and everyone downstairs on your own.
I'm well aware of how many people it has to be.
You have to call it off.
Do you want to tell Mr. Wu that we missed the one chance to get our hands on his fucking rice ball? Because I don't. We have one window of opportunity and we're going to use it.
Fine. How?
Leave him to bleed. He's to make some calls and try and find a replacement in the next... Shit, in the next 30 minutes, call Danny if he doesn't pick up. Try and get hold of that, you know, Irish Pete.
What about him?
Let's put a bullet in him. I don't care.
I'm not a murderer, I don't intend to start now. Pass me diphenoxin and a couple of cable ties.
You stay where you are.
Look, you said you wouldn't hurt me.
No, I said I wouldn't kill you. That still leaves lots of painful options.
Not good at maths, are you, mate?
What's that supposed to mean?
Minus one, plus one.
That means zero.
Yeah, zero problems. Look, you need someone to help you out. And I need someone not to stick a fucking syringe in me.
Why on earth would I trust you?
Because you don't have a choice. Just like I don't.
See your point.
Are you serious?
Are you going to go to the basement?
We've got no idea who he is.
After tonight, I'm not going to see him again. What difference does it make?
The difference is this guy looks like trouble.
Well, Mr. Wu is trouble, and we've made a deal with him we can't go back on.
What do you say?
I don't care who does what, as long as I get my cut.
You better not fuck this up.
What about the money?
Don't push your luck.
I'm taking his risk, so I want his share.
Fuck off!
Shut up, idiot.
I'll be worth the money.
Okay, I'll tell you what, you two split 50-50, that's the deal.
Done.
You can't do this!
It's done. Put this on.
You're joking.
We'll find you something.
Try and turn him in. Do I keep my mouth shut and take the money? Mystery ladies and difficult choices. So much for the quiet night.
I think you need to tell me what we're doing here.
Nerve going already?
I'd just like to be prepared, that's all.
A very powerful Chinese clan called the Choi's are here tonight to reacquire a porcelain ball that has been in the possession of their family for over 1,000 years.
Reacquire? What went wrong?
A careless business transaction.
So we're here to help them get it back?
We're here to stop them getting it back.
I presume you're not buying it.
What do you think?
Great. You know, I gave up stealing a long time ago.
To do what?
To study.
Then tonight's your lucky night.
How do you work that out?
Because the only thing studying will get you is unemployment.
Failed education is still no excuse for stealing, you know.
We're stealing from people who are prepared to spend millions on a piece of pottery when there are far more worthy causes in the world.
What on your worthy cause are you?
Tonight I am.
Yeah, I guess you could see it that way. You know, maybe you've got a point about relieving some of these people of a sliver of their money.
Welcome to Hainsworth's. The second part of the auction has just begun.
Thank you.
Nine ten to my left. Thank you, sir. 9:10. 9:20.
9:20, thank you.
I see you.
9:30, again to my left. 9:40, do I hear 9:40? 9:40, thank you, sir. Looking for 9:50. 9:50 to my left. Do I hear 9:60? Fair warning, I'm selling. 9:50 once, 9:50 twice. Sold for £950,000. This marvellous 12th century cabinet with its hidden compartment, which is
150 grand for its
time. Just try to keep it powder dry.
I'm sorry, if I had that kind of money, I wouldn't spend it on a fucking sideboard. Sorry.
Why don't you try not talking at all?
So we come to what I feel must be the highlight of our sale this evening, lot 247. And to introduce it, first I'd like to pass you over to our expert, Miss Katie Tran. Katie.
What we have here is an absolutely exquisite example of late Ming Dynasty porcelain.
Don't stand still, mate. Is the ball there?
One of only three remaining examples of the red phoenix pattern known to be in existence. Sebastian, if you would please.
Thank you very much indeed, Katie. It is a truly exceptional piece, the sale of which cannot be passed without remarking that its owner, Mr. Samuel Parr, who is far too modest to mention it himself, has agreed to donate 50% of the sale proceeds to the Chinese Art Restoration Fund.
Yeah, and he can't afford it.
What did we say about not looking?
And so, we shall begin the selling. Thank you, Katie. Thank you, Sebastian. And I would like to start the bidding, please, at £2 million. £2 million. Thank you, madam. £2 million I have to my left. Three I'm looking for. Do I hear three? Three at the back. Thank you, sir. Do I hear four? Four. Four to the lady. Thank you, madam. Four I'm bidding.
What the fuck are you doing?
Do I hear five?
Yeah, what the fuck are you doing?
Five, I get 20% on the sale price, don't we?
On the phone. Five I have. Do I hear six? Six I'm looking for. Six to my right. Thank you, sir.
How powerful did you say these toys are?
Do I now hear seven? Seven I have to the lady. Thank you,
stop bidding.
Seven. Do I hear eight? Eight I'm looking for. Eight with you, sir, to your bid. Looking for nine.
Matt, stop her.
Do I hear nine? Nine in the room? Nine I'm looking for. Nine to the lady, thank you, madam.
Christ
I'm
almighty.
Looking for 9-5, ladies and gentlemen, 9-5. 9-5, 9-5 to my right. So do I hear 10?
Matt, stop this.
Don't talk to him, talk to me.
We're looking to break 10, thank you, madam.
Are you out of your fucking
10 we
mind?
Have, we are at 8 figures in the room, ladies and gentlemen. 10 is your bid, madam. It's against you now, sir, so do I hear 10-5.
You are so getting lumbered with this.
10-5. 10-5 I have. Thank you. Now do I hear 11? 11 I have with the lady.
I'm gonna
again,
have a hard
thank
time.
You, madam.
Do you have a
11, it's
this?
Your bid, madam.
Yeah, gut feeling.
11,
okay.
So.
Because you know, price
we have 11-5.
Logarithmic curve, derivative 11-5. Zero. So the chances of getting away with another
your
bid.
Your bid at 11, madam.
What is
11.5%.
Trust me.
11-5. 11-5 I have. Thank you very much, sir. 11-5, it's your bid. It's against you now, man. It's against you, sir. 11-5. 11-5 with you, sir. Fair warning. I'm selling. 11-5 once. 11-5 twice. 12 million I have. Thank you, madam. 12 it is. So do I hear 12-5? 12-5 I'm looking for. 12-5. It's your bid at 12, madam. Looking for 12-5. 12-5. 12-5 I have to my right. Thank you, sir. 12-5. So do I hear 13? It's against you now, madam. 12-5. Are we all out? At 12-5, fair warning. I'm selling. 12-5 once. 12-5 twice. So, to the gentleman on my right for £12.5 million. Thank you very much.
Let's get the hell out of here. wall doesn't turn on mathematics, you know.
Yeah, well, mine does.
Well, maybe that's your problem.
Right now, you're my bloody problem.
A problem that just increased your cut by about 25%? Now that's mathematics.
All right, where to?
The basement. Jeffrey's going to call the lift from downstairs.
Okay, and then?
Then you're going to take out the security guard.
I'm sorry, I'm going to do what?
Just follow Jeffrey's instructions, darling. We're a couple, remember?
So what do? Do I play along and try and get out of this later? Or do I try and stop this little crime wave dead in its tracks? Out of all of the probabilities, how did I end up here?
Follow me.
Wait here. When Simon gives the word, move out to the middle of the corridor and wait for the guard to come to you. Just say you got lost looking for the box. Simon, freeze the guard's image.
He's not going to believe that.
I'll handle that.
Alert the guard or let this play out. I might not get another chance.
Okay, Matt, go.
Stop right there, sir. This is a restricted area. What do you think you're doing down here?
I got lost coming out the lift.
No, this floor's staff only.
Oh, I was looking for the toilet.
No, you wouldn't have come down here unless you meant to.
Simon, we're at the door.
Okay, you have to enter both codes simultaneously.
Got it?
Okay, timing is key here. The left keypad is 309220.
Okay, punch in the right code and I'm good.
On the right keypad, enter this. 085209, okay?
Got it.
Now both hit enter at the same time.
Okay, 3, 2... Got it, we're in. Thanks, mate. Take him with you. Simon, I'll come to the front to get you.
I have to admit, I wouldn't have thought you'd live up to the task.
Thanks, I guess.
And as far as I can see, you're beginning to like playing this game.
Yeah, I definitely shouldn't, I?
We have it.
Let's fuck for that.
Just get out of it.
Nothing here. Nothing there. Ladies and gentlemen, we are back in society.
Let me see it. I want to see the bomb.
Just wait. This thing stays in the bag until we get to Wu's place and turns it into money.
Too fucking right.
We've got to take a left. Some Shoreditch High Street. Hong Kong City restaurant.
Sounds classy.
What are we going to do about this comedian?
Give him to me. I'll pop it.
Whoa, hold on.
Not here. Just keep him quiet until we get rid of this bowl.
Jeffrey, you're not serious.
There should be some gaffer tape in the back somewhere.
Look out! Mei Ling, can you hear me? Open your eyes. Okay, there's petrol, look, we gotta get out. Right? Fuck. Come on. To Wu's to finish what you started.
Mr. Wu's?
Yeah, well, that was the plan, wasn't it? What do you want to do, Mei Ling? Do you want to stay here? Mei Ling? Look at me. Look at me. You can't not decide, okay? You have to do something. Oh, look. Come the fuck on, okay? We've got to go.
Welcome to Hong Kong City. Table for two.
We're here to see someone.
Table for four. Four on me, please.
It's going well.
Excuse me. We don't want to eat.
No problem. Bar this way. Four on me, please.
No. Mate. We want to see the manager.
You want to see the manager?
Want to see the manager.
You're not even eaten?
No.
Your health inspector?
No.
Look, is Mr. Wu here?
Mr. Wu?
Mr. Wu, yeah.
Never heard of Mr. Wu.
Well, how about the Queen, mate? You heard of her?
Memory clearing.
You listen to me. Tell Mr. Wu that Mei Ling and Jeffrey are here to see him. You tell him right now, or you can pay the consequences.
Okay. You, wait here. Have fortune cookie.
Fortune does not come twice. Misfortune does not come alone.
Didn't know any better. I say you picked that one on purpose.
What does yours say?
Not telling.
Four on me, please.
Tell me.
No.
What's your business?
Why have you brought this here?
Because we had a deal.
I made no such deal. I have never seen you before.
Look, the man who made the deal is dead, okay? That's why we brought you your bow.
My bow? Atam, turn beige over here. Managing to steal that bow. It's quite impressive. But choosing to steal it in the first place is nothing short of insanity.
We stole this for you.
I gave no such order. Not to you or anyone else.
What?
To steal that bow is not only madness. It is also suicide. To the Choi family, possession of that bowl is a question of honor. They have fought wars for it. Its price is beyond measure. And I know how much they paid for it tonight. And I do not intend to add my life to the bill. Now get out!
What should we do with her?
If the choice catch you with it, you are dead. If you destroy it, you are dead. If you bring it back here, you are dead.
Doesn't really answer my question now, does it?
Not my problem. Atam! Go on, Kordei Tohoi! Goodbye. We will not meet again.
Fucking great. I still want to know what my fortune cookie said.
Sure. A young man may trust his ears, but a wise man trusts his heart.
Did you know about the choice? How dangerous they are? You fucking did, didn't you?
You knew everything Wu just told us, and yet you still bid against them and stole their damn bowl.
This doesn't really help us, does it?
It was the choice that ran us off the road.
We need a plan.
What do you suggest?
Hiding until we come up with one. I know a place.
No. No, we go to the police, Mei Ling. Like we should have done in the first place.
That's a terrible plan.
Well, it's better than hiding away from the inevitable. Look, we need to get rid of this bowl before the choice get rid of us.
If we take it to the police, they will arrest us.
Not for definite, no. I'll make it an even 50%.
You do realize your calculations on my gut are doing exactly the same thing? You just need the numbers to make you feel better.
My numbers are based on the information that we have, yeah? And rational mathematical algorithms.
Well, my gut feelings are based on experience and my entire subconscious. Do you know how many percent of your brain's activity are conscious? Probably less than one. Now that's a percentage. So trust me when I tell you that going to the police is a bad idea.
Did you believe Wu? They knew nothing about the job.
You look convincing, didn't you?
Yeah, that's not what I asked you.
John, thank you. And good evening from M Channel News. I'm on the service.
Not adding much to this conversation, mate.
I don't know. I thought we were delivering the ball for 20% job done. I should be back at home by now, soaking in the bath. Shit.
What?
There's no boss.
Somebody must want this thing. Why has no one tried to contact us? Is there any way we can get to Jeff's phone messages? Or what about that place in Chelsea? Maybe they've tried to contact us there.
Just shut up, could you?
Why'd you do that?
Because I felt like it.
History.
I'll try.
What's wrong?
Where is it? I don't know. I don't know where it is.
We've all had a very long night. If you don't come to your senses, I can assure you that yours will become even longer.
Where is the ball?
Look, I haven't got it. Okay, it was taken from me and now I don't know where it is.
Lies.
Look, I haven't got your fucking rice bowl, or...
Disrespect, we're punished. Now for the final time, where is the real ball?
I don't understand.
Where is the ball you took from the auction, not the copy you had in your pocket? The original. The original ball that you stole, where?
What the fuck is that?
You know where the ball is. You and your lady friend. Next door. Both of you know.
One of you will tell.
What have you done to her?
So you admit to your partnership with her?
What have you done to her? Look, what the fuck is this? What have you done to her?
What have you done to her? I don't understand
what the fuck you're saying to me.
Ball equals pain. The longer you have ball, the longer you have pain. Very simple mathematics.
Fuck! Fucking hell. No, I haven't got your fucking rice bowl, okay? Fuck!
I don't care if you have it or your girl. The ball is ours. First to tell truth is free. The other is punished.
The classic prisoner's dilemma, game theory first term. Whatever I tell them lives or dies on what Mei Ling tells them, and vice versa. If our answers are inconsistent, one of us dies.
Choose.
What?
Choose punishment. Know your fate.
The long one.
Good choice. Very honorable death. One turn and it twists your intestines like a key. Death comes slowly over a long, long time.
Great.
Where is the ball? The original ball.
Can I trust her to be reasonable? or will she keep quiet? Because if she does that, she dies.
Look, I am genuinely telling you. Okay, I know nothing about swapping the original for a fake. Okay, I was forced to be part of the robbery. I had no choice. I knew nothing about the plan apart from what to do next. There is nothing I can tell you that's of any use. You're just wasting your time with me. That's the absolute truth.
Gong Dai Wa.
Oh.
Where is the original? Do we repeat?
I don't know.
Second round, like I thought, the girl kept quiet.
Where?
Fuck. She followed a strategy. If I get this wrong, then Mei-Ling gets one of those knives through the stomach. And so do I.
God, I don't know. What can I tell you?
This can only continue. Where is the original?
God, fuck you. Fuck you. God, fuck.
Every finger, then every knuckle, continuing every joint. You will see daylight, but still, it will continue. Where is the original?
Christ, that girl's tough. Do I even believe that she's in there? Is she a part of this? Is she a part of their gang and they think that I'm the only one who knows where the original is? Am I just prolonging the inevitable? Fuck. Fuck. Do I trust her?
Then I'll see you in the fucking morning, mate.
The lady says you lied to us. That you're the only one who knows where it is.
Oh,
for fuck's sake! Can we please speak in fucking English?
I didn't say you're the only one who knows where it is. I said you're the only one who can get to it.
It's okay.
Decided. You bring us the ball, she stays hostage. If you fail, she dies. Enough. Time to go.
I didn't mean for any of this to happen. I'm sorry.
Where's the original?
I don't know.
Done to us. What the hell is he playing at? Rich fucking bastard. What the fuck am I doing? Am I really doing this? All right. Just keep walking. Just keep moving.
if you ask me, small boy.
For the police.
It's okay. We're just having a laugh, aren't we?
Yeah, sure. We...
Blimey, that guy Lily choked me. Shit. The auction guy, Jeffrey, nearly strangled. He had access to the bowl after the expert on stage had it, right before we stole it. Right. How do I find him? Sorry to call this late, but is Sebastian at home?
Who's speaking, please?
It's Stan from work. I heard he was in an accident. Is he all right? Is he at home?
No, he's not well. He's been taken to the hospital. There's a serious concussion. It's horrible.
I'm really sorry to hear that. Where did they take him?
They took him to St. Thomas's, but they won't let me visit until the morning.
St. Thomas's, thank you. I'm really sorry this happened.
Don't worry, it's not your fault.
I'm sorry, though. All right. Let's pay this poor guy a visit. Hi. You work here?
As you can see.
I thought you had some party to go to. Some bet for a grand.
Why do you think I'm back here doing an extra shift?
Yeah, well, things would have gotten way worse for you.
Oh, don't start. What brings you here?
I'm here to see someone. Can you tell me what room Sebastian Leclerc's in, please? Is he here?
I'm sorry, I can't help you.
Oh, come on. It's just a room number.
What? Like it was just a key?
Oh, come on.
Good night.
Look, this isn't about some entry ticket to some party, yeah? This is way bigger.
What's so important that you need to see him now?
It's complicated. But ever since we met this evening, my night has just got worse and worse.
Well, ditto.
Oh, look. I know you think I fucked you over, but chasing you out of that garage might have just saved your life.
Is that the best you can do?
I can give you the keys next weekend.
Too late. Too little, too late. Liz, can you deal with this visitor, please? Can't give him the information he needs.
Fuck. Hi.
Hello.
I'm here to visit Sebastian Leclerc.
Bear with me a second. Oh no, no patient by that name, sorry.
Oh, I must have misheard the name of the hospital. Thanks anyway.
are you doing here?
You remember me, right?
You shouldn't be here. Nurse? Nurse!
Now you listen to me, mate. I'm a peaceful man, okay? I do not want to hurt you. But if you try that shit again, I swear to God, the bits of you that hurt are gonna get a whole lot worse. Do you understand me? Do we have a deal?
Yes.
Good. Now tell me about your deal with Samuel Parr. I know you replaced the porcelain rice bowl with a forgery.
That's a lie.
Do you want to discuss that with the police, mate? Perhaps have a little gander at the surveillance footage with them.
They've already seen the footage.
Of the robbery, maybe. But what about the footage of you after you left the main auction room?
Of where?
Backstage.
You know nothing. You do not scare me. There's nothing you can do. And it's just a matter of time until the choice will find you.
Where's the rice bowl?
It's stolen. Look at me. I was beaten up.
Where is it? Where'd you put the original?
I didn't put it anywhere.
I know you switched it, Sebastian. Where is it?
I didn't take it.
This is a definite line. Do I really want to cross this? Tell me where it is, now. Where?
I swapped it. In the elevator, I swapped the original with the forgery, and I hid it.
The cabinet? Paul's cabinet he bought in auction. There was a secret compartment in it, right?
Yes.
Is that where it is? Is the bowl still inside?
I don't know. This is the truth. The security took everything to the safe storage after the robbery, and they brought me here to the hospital.
Safe storage? So it's still inside Hainsworth?
Maybe.
When will it be shipped to Paul?
Small items such as this, mostly the next day. But Paul has friends on the board. He probably managed to ship it out tonight.
So you could have the bowl already?
Yes, possible.
Where's that bloody bowl? Feels like a 50-50 chance. Oh, painkillers, thank Christ. Will this get me into the vault?
Yes, if you can get to it, yes.
Never here, right?
Yes. And you never heard about a hidden compartment.
Get well soon.
Yeah. Connor.
Thank you.
be with you in a moment.
No rush. Long flight.
How can I help you?
I'm here to pick up an item.
What lot was it?
It was an item bought last night by Mr. Samuel Parr.
No. No, it's not on my list. Do you have your documentation?
You're telling me you don't?
I don't seem to.
Oh, God. I could get the documentation halfway across the world to me, but couldn't get them downstairs to you. Oh, for goodness sake.
Let me take another look. Oh, here we are. I do apologise. Oh, it's scheduled for dispatch, not collection.
Oh, this is intolerable.
Perhaps you should talk to Mr. Quinn about it.
Yes, I would very much like to speak to Mr. Quinn about this. First floor?
Second.
Room 13?
Correct.
Great. So this card.
Doors closing.
What do you think you're doing?
Your colleague let me in.
Who?
Mr. Quinn.
Mr. Quinn?
Mr. Quinn, yeah.
Wait here.
Going down?
Yeah, thank you.
Ground floor?
Car park.
You don't work here?
Picking up. Mr. Quinn sent me down. Oh shit, do I look shifty?
The car park's just through those rooms.
Thank you.
That's a lot of fucking money. I could just walk away with this. Hello?
It's me.
Mate.
I don't have much time. Have you got the ball?
Yeah. In the back of Ainsworth, I've got it in my hand.
Don't bring it here.
What are you talking about? They're gonna fucking kill you.
I can't do that anyway. We need to prove to them that this was part of the plan right from the start.
Any suggestions?
We need to get part of this.
Solzina.
Mei, don't go wrong.
Mei Ling. Fuck. What do I do? Do I risk going to Pa's house to get us both out of this? Or do I take it to the choice? Now's my chance.
Nico, 开多机.
Moment, sir.
We've not been disappointed by your cooperation.
So we're free.
You're free to go.
Where's my leg?
Room 731.
What did he say?
Goodbye.
Thank you.
Thank you.